Buenos dias or good morning from another day in Isabela, Galapagos. So we are on our second day in Isabela. So this Isabela island, it is one of the four inhabited islands of Galapagos. It's one of the largest island in Galapagos. So overall 60% of Galapagos landmass is in Isabela, and there are 4 to 5 active volcanoes in Isabela, I think 5. So we are towards the south of Isabela, which is Puerto Villamil, the port town. Nearby volcano which we can access is the Sierra Negra Volcano, which last erupted in 2018. So today we'll hike that for almost 4 to 5 hours, then we'll come back and have a snorkeling tour in the evening. So Sierra Negra means the black one, so it's possibly coming from the color of the lava. We heard quite a lot about this volcano, and this will be our first volcano hike in our life, so excited for it.
Savere hum log nikal gaye beach pe just for a quick morning walk. अब वापस जा रहे हैं होटल ब्रेकफास्ट करने. इट्स 6 AM इन द मॉर्निंग, नो 6:30 इन द मॉर्निंग. 6 o'clock हम लोग निकल चुके थे, एंड वी हैव टू डू क्विक ब्रेकफास्ट बिकॉज 6:30 ओपन हो जाएगा. यहाँ पे टाइमिंग्स बहुत जल्दी जल्दी होते हैं. ब्रेकफास्ट टाइमिंग इज 6:30 to 7:30 मैक्स 8. डिनर टाइमिंग इज 7 ओनली मैक्स. दे विल वेट फॉर 7:30. दिस इज गुड फॉर अस, हमें प्रॉब्लम नहीं है
बिकॉज आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ द टूर्स स्टार्टेड अर्ली
मॉर्निंग एज 7. तो हमारा भी 7 o'clock पिकअप है, तो उससे पहले हमें 6:30 ब्रेकफास्ट कर लेना है, तो हम जा रहे हैं ब्रेकफास्ट कर.
Sierra Negra.
That's the volcano. It's all misty around and it's drizzling. Hum log sab rain jacket mein. Oh, it's drizzling. I should do this.
The Sierra Negra Volcano is one of 5 active volcanoes located on Isabela Island in the Galapagos Islands. Sierra Negra is the only volcano that visitors are allowed to hike, and it is only accessible with a guide. Hiking the volcano takes around 5 to 6 hours from start to finish.
We are here in the southeast side. Right now we're going to walk 1 kilometer. It's muddy trail for 2 kilometers. 1 kilometer is a little tired. After that, we're going to walk over flat land.
Okay.
In the halfway, we're going to wait in for good information about the Galapagos Island formation, at sport, the timber, lake. After the 3 kilometers, there we have microclimb here. This weather start to change quickly.
Okay.
Right? It's drier on the other side, where we're going now, in the northeast side.
Even though the incline of the trail is gradual, the hike can be strenuous for some due to distance and heat of the equatorial sun, or because the trail gets muddy when it rains.
Okay. We have a 16 kilometer, 8 kilometer, 9 kilometer, 5 hour walk to wait.
Okay.
I will be back here 1 o'clock. 1 o'clock, we are here. The open bus is waiting for us over there. I'm a driver, I'm guiding, I have the key here. Okay? Question, do you have a question? No?
No?
During the first portion of our hike, the terrain was very lush and green, but the dirt paths had become muddy because of the rain.
We've already walked 2 kilometers and I haven't shot a video because it's a very slippery terrain, muddy and slippery. And my shoes are giving up. And Orko ka to soul nikal gaya. He's dead. Orko, you're fine? See. So, another kilometer and the trail is supposed to go flat and dry. Probably. Let's see. The entire trail till 3 kilometers is muddy because it's raining. So, humne aise grass dhoond dhoond ke bahut carefully walk karna pad raha hai. पैर की तो हालत खराब हो गई है, जूते पूरे गीले हैं, मोजे पूरे गीले हैं, एंड वी ऑलवेज बिहाइंड द ग्रुप, बट इट्स फाइन. ऑर्को इज वॉकिंग, एक किलोमीटर के बाद दे से दैट वी आर गोना गेट सम ड्राई लैंड, तब शायद हालत थोड़ी बेटर होगी, बट लेट्स सी. बट दीज हाइकर्स आर सो गुड, उनकी स्पीड कितनी अच्छी है, आई डोंट नो हाउ, प्रोबेबली वी आर बिगिनर्स एंड ऑल्सो दीज शूज आर नॉट हेल्पिंग.
सो वी हैव कवर्ड ऑलमोस्ट 3 किलोमीटर ऑफ डॉट रोड,
5 लेफ्ट,
but that will be a different landscape.
So we made our way along the muddy dirt paths and occasionally stopped to observe different species of plants and birds. As we walked, our guide told us stories about the volcano as well as information about plants and wildlife that make this area their home. Once you reach the top of the volcano, the last portion of the hike brings you over a rocky landscape with little vegetation. You can still see the rocky landscape that were decimated by lava years prior. It is easy to imagine that this is once what the entire chain of Galapagos Islands looked like. We saw life growing and evolving right in front of our eyes. And we were able to see full circle how the islands came to be.
So now we are standing at a viewpoint of Sierra Negra Volcano, which we have been last 2 hours se hike kar rahe. So you can see people are walking there. We have not gone because my Shuka soul was coming out and I want to keep it till the way back because the trail is little muddy. So that's why we stopped here and we'll possibly start walking back. But before that, I'll just show you the landscape. We are first time hiking in a volcano and it looks amazing. Like you see, huge dome-shaped kind of mountain hills, I'll say. These are formed by last volcanic eruption that was happened in 1979. 2018 is the closest time when there was a small eruption in Sierra Negra, but this landscape was primarily formed in the 1979 eruption. This was a huge eruption, like our guide told. You see, the landscape still looks so fresh from the eruption. That it doesn't seem like that it's almost what 30-35 years have been passed. So mere piche aap dekh pa rahe ho jo landscape hai, that's towards Santa Cruz or San Cristobal Island, and towards my right, if you see, it crosses over to Ulf volcano, which is another volcano in Isabela, and then you have Fernandina Island, so which is a very beautiful island. But those Ulf volcano or Fernandina Island, you can only go via cruise boat. If you are taking a cruise boat, make sure they stop at least in Fernandina. It's a beautiful island, but since we are doing a land-based tour, we will not be able to go to Fernandina.
The views overlooking the crater and the island from the top of the volcano were spectacular. We could see the entire volcanic crater on one side and views of the lush island landscape and ocean on the other. Eventually, it was time to head back down the volcano and it was the same trail back to the starting point. Thank you.
don't hike a volcano in Galapagos if you don't like this and this. Oh my god, the road never ends and it's so muddy. We walked this trail while going up also, but we couldn't record a video. Right now we are hopefully close, so we are recording kyunki aise bhi ye niche ki taraf ja raha hai, and I think major mud part we have crossed. I literally want to throw this shoes, but मैं अभी यहाँ से निकल के Amazon जाना है and I don't know कि हमें कहाँ पे क्या जूते की ज़रूरत पड़ेगी and I can't buy a shoe in South America. So we are going to go back to the hotel. Both of us are going to wash this shoe. Orko का तो shoe sole भी निकल रहा है. I don't know how he is gonna manage, but yeah, that's how it is. So we are back from our volcano hike and we just went to the lagoon opposite our hotel, जहाँ पे basically flamingos हैं. So we were seeing that and we are back now. Hotel में जा रहे हैं, इसका कुछ करना है and then हम थोड़ा सा half an hour के लिए jacuzzi में जाएंगे. So let's go. ये भी कर लिया, jacuzzi भी कर लिया. फिर hotel का ही jacuzzi है and the view. Although we have only 20 minutes to stay, and that's the beach. Agar dikhe to, that's ocean. Udhar volcanoes and idhar orko.
20 minutes in the hot jacuzzi, and we were back up on our foot again, ready for our next activity of the day, which was snorkeling. Now this was our second snorkeling after the first one, which was lost in tiroras, and this was our second snorkeling activity in Concha de Perla. Now Concha de Perla is a natural pool in a mangrove forest that you can explore without a guide because it is one of the few snorkeling locations outside of a national park. You may swim comfortably with sea lions, penguins, sea turtles, iguanas and many other marine animals in the protected lagoon. Now in order to reach there, make your way to the boat port. Take the small broad walk on the left facing the pier just before the boat pier and proceed about 3 minutes to the lagoon. You may either walk 20 minutes from town to pier where the broad walk to the lagoon begins or take a cab. We would obviously recommend to walk because it is not at all far from the main town of Puerto Villamil. Once you reach the lagoon, make sure you carry your own snorkeling gear because this is a free lagoon and free snorkeling spot. Take the snorkeling gear and just jump right into the water and enjoy your snorkeling.
Thank you.
Okay, so jab tak aap ye playful sea lion dekho, which we found on our way back from the lagoon, that is the snorkeling spot, time for some honest opinion. Concha Perla is one of the very few free snorkeling spot in the Galapagos Islands and specifically Isabela. Aur yahan pe bahut sare log aate hain snorkeling ke liye, and we have heard ki ye snorkeling spot bahut acha hai. No doubt acha hai because you get to see the ocean and explore the underwaters, but hame visibility utni clear nahi mili jo aapko video pe dikh raha hoga. Visibility was not crystal clear, unlike what we have heard. Also, when you get into the lagoon, kuch distance tak visibility hai, uske baad bilkul bhi visibility nahi thi. Now that I don't know if, ya fir that's the usual, ki because of tide, visibility mein difference aa sakta hai. With respect to spottings, we did spot sea lions, we did spot stingrays, but ye dono cheeze towards the lower visibility or no visibility end thi. That is why we could not capture it in the video clearly. Baki shallower end pe, jahan pe visibility thi, wahan pe different kinds of fish thi. All in all, it was a nice activity, just that hamare mind mein jitna build up tha, उतना नहीं था.
तो हम लोग आफ्टरनून में वोल्केनो ट्रैक करने के से वापस आके वी वेंट टू कोंचा पार्ला, दैट्स अ स्नॉर्किंग स्नॉर्कलिंग प्लेस. सो वहाँ पे हम गए थे स्नॉर्कलिंग के लिए. अभी हम लोग वॉच कर रहे हैं सनसेट, एंड आज का डे वॉज सुपर 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 हेक्टिक, क्योंकि हम लोग सवेरे 7 बजे निकले थे वोल्केनो हाइक के लिए. उसके बाद वापस आके फ्रेश होके लंच करके वी वेंट फॉर स्नॉर्कलिंग, एंड देन शाम को 5 बजे वापस आके वी गेट इन द बीच रेस्टिंग एंड एंजॉयिंग.
मेरे और औरको को ना स्क्वायर से प्यार हो गया, तो जब भी हो हम यहाँ पे आके बैठ जा रहे हैं. तो ऐसे टेबल्स हैं, दीज आर लाइक मस्ट ट्रीज, कैनपीज भी दिए हुए हैं, एंड दिस इज आई थिंक आर्टिफिशियल ग्रास देव पुट है ना औरको. एंड देन देर आर शॉप्स अराउंड, पूरा स्क्वायर है. यहाँ पे बच्चों के खेलने की कुछ स्विंग्स बना रखे हैं, एंड इवनिंग में वी नोटिस जो टाउन के लोग हैं वो यहाँ पे आके बैठ जाते हैं, अपने बच्चों को लेके आके छोड़ देते हैं यहाँ खेलने के लिए. तो हम मैं और को ना हर इवनिंग आके यहाँ बैठ रहे हैं, बिकॉज हमारी टूर्स होती है मॉर्निंग टिल इवनिंग. इवनिंग में फ्रेश होके हम यहाँ पे आके वॉक कर लेते हैं, हमारे होटल पास में यहाँ बैठ जाते हैं.
बीइंग ऑल टूरिस्ट इन इसला इजाबेला,